Hey guys, I'm Mary Langwish, and I'm here to share with you part 3 of my video series, How to Put On Your Own Art Show and Art Exhibition. So this is for the artist who's interested in showing their work, displaying their work, getting more people to see it in person, and possibly even buy. So if that's you, let's get started. I do have part 1 and 2 linked down in the description below. I hope you go check those out before you finish this video because there's some helpful hints before you put on your show. But let's get into part 3 of this video series. So like this video, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and let's get started. So this video is literally about getting your show completely together, hanging your art, making it happen. So this particular step will happen, and this will depend on your venue, but a week or two before your show, up to a few days before your show. And if you're like me, sometimes the night before, try to avoid that. So the first thing we want to talk about is layout. So you have all your art, it's framed, it's ready to go, but how do you put it on the wall? So some tips for what I do is I lay out my pictures, like maybe prop them up against the wall so that I can see them all in the room, space them out a little bit. And when you're putting them together, and I kind of move around, organize them, put different ones next to other ones to kind of see how things are gonna look. So you wanna think about putting similar pieces together. So I don't mean that you have to put all your blue paintings together, all your purple paintings together, or all your landscapes together. You don't have to do that. I would recommend not doing that. But you want to put similar paintings together, like similar color ranges, so that you don't have like one super bright picture or photograph or painting next to a bunch of dull, more muted colored paintings, because it's going to distract from the more beautiful muted pictures. Every painting you have is beautiful. You don't want one to overpower another. You want them to complement each other really well. So when you're putting these out, laying them out, figuring out what's gonna go next to what the best, think of the whole show kind of as a painting. You're trying to compose it with an interesting composition, with interesting colors and textures, not distracting from another thing. Just you want unity and you want each piece to complement each other. Also think a little bit about the movement. Are you putting clumps of paintings together, or are you kind of keeping them horizontal around the room? You can decide, but you want to make sure it works well for your art, different sizes, together, all that stuff you want to think about. And the way that I do it is just lay it out on the floor first, lay it out against the wall before you do any hanging. Then once you feel like you know what your placement is for each of these in the room or on the walls, then you can start hanging. Now obviously before you start hanging stuff, you wanna make sure you have all the stuff that you need to hang, whether that's nails and a hammer or command strips or sticky tack or whatever you need to be able to hang stuff, make sure you have all that stuff ahead of time. Now when you're hanging art, I've always done it this way. You wanna hang it at the average height of a person, which is about 5 feet from the ground. So it's gonna be eye level to most people. That's kind of where you wanna aim most of your work. Obviously, if you have a clump of paintings, you want them to kind of straddle that line a little bit. But then if they're in a row, you wanna keep them around the 5 foot mark from the floor. And obviously you need to figure out what works best for your art and for the space that you're working in. Then the next thing is making labels and descriptions. So I usually just use my computer, whether it's just a document or Photoshop or something, to create my labels for each painting. Now you have to decide, does your label have the title of your work? Does it have your name? Does it have the medium of the work used? Does it have the size? Does it have the price? Does it have your website? There's a lot of things you can put on a label, and you just have to decide what's best for you and what you want on there, what kind of information you want to give to your viewers. You don't need all the information, but you might want some important stuff like the size and the price or the name. People like to know the name of a piece. Those types of things might be kind of helpful. I personally print mine on just sort of a cardstock, and then I cut them out, and sometimes I've backed them with a nice colored paper, or I'll glue them to a small piece of foam core so they kind of stick out from the wall a little bit, creating a little bit of a three dimensions. A little bit of a shadow, which can make it a little bit professional and interesting looking. And it's super easy to do. You also want to think about, where does this label go? Does it go to the bottom right, bottom left, center underneath the piece, off to the side, to the right or the left? Think about that and then keep it consistent over every picture on the wall. Then you want to think a little bit about the flow of the show. Where are people entering from? Where will they start? Will you have a description of kind of your thought process, your reason for the theme or the series or anything like that, your inspiration, the mediums you used, how you challenged yourself, whatever you want to say. Sometimes a nice little description at the front of your show or somewhere in your show can be kind of a fun little thing for your viewers to read. But sometimes not having that is fine. You don't have to have that much information. You want the art to speak for itself. That's great. And this is everyone's favorite part. You should always have food or some sort of snack or drink. Now, obviously this will depend a little bit on your venue and that if that's allowed or not, but I highly recommend it. People will come if there's food. Just some finger foods are great. Sometimes I put little bowls around the room on windowsills or on little tables or next to paintings that have just little candies in them. And it gets people to kind of walk around, they snack, and they hate me for it, but it makes them walk around and look at art. So everyone loves candy. So yeah, that works great. You really are just trying to make it a fun environment for different people and for lots of people. So food is a big one. Music is a big one. Put together a playlist of some of your favorite songs and make sure there's enough of them so that it can kind of last a long time, and then put it on repeat so you don't even have to think about it. You have a speaker off in the corner, let it play, let it be perfect background music, not too loud, enough that people can feel like there's stuff happening. And then some fun activities. So let's talk about some ideas along those lines. Some ideas for some interactive things. It's sometimes a fun idea to have a guest book so that people, when they come to your show, can put down their name or sign a little thing so that you know who was at your show and they feel like they've kind of been a part of it. You could also have a group project. I've done lots of these before. It gets people involved in creating their own art, which I think is so awesome, and it's just fun. Or maybe you have an interactive art piece, like a photo booth, or something that everyone can create together, or you just have a bunch of art supplies out for everyone to play with. Or maybe you have a small drawing contest with a prize. It's a little helpful when you do one of these things that includes art supplies and making art that you have maybe a little separation of space. You don't want people flinging paint around close to your art that's all finished and beautiful and on display. So having a little separation is nice. In my previous space, I had two separate rooms that were perfect. I could have one that was more for food and for group activities, and the other one was a gallery to display art in. Of course, it's not necessary, but just something to think about. But of course, all these different activity ideas just brings people of all ages and different likes. And again, like I said in part one of this video series, not everyone is gonna like your work, and you wanna maybe bring some people that maybe don't like your work specifically, but like you as a person, or like what you're doing, or love art and wanna support you. This gives them a chance to come and enjoy themselves as well. So when you have people come to your show, obviously the hope is that people will buy your work, but in all honesty, most of the time you don't sell much. Sometimes you do, and that's great. But sometimes it's helpful to have a little something smaller that people can purchase. A little gift, a little token. For me personally, I make my artwork into note cards and sell those, and those are huge sellers. People will buy tons of those, even if they can't afford a painting. So something like that, whether it's stickers, cards, calendar, apparel, notebooks, whatever, something small, something that's cheaper than a painting, is sometimes a fun idea to get your audience involved in supporting you and happy to support you, and then they get to go home with something of yours as well. It gets people excited about your work, about you, and it makes them tell others about you as well. And then last but not least, once your show has started or about to start, you wanna create some hype. So I have my studio on Facebook as a business page, and with the business page on Facebook, at least I think you can only do it on the business page, is you can schedule posts, and I think you can do this on other social medias as well. Ahead of time, schedule some different posts with some photos hinting at what is about to come and reminding people of the place and the time. So it gets people excited to come to your show, and it reminds them because people forget. Another good idea is to do a short live video on your Instagram or social media at the start of the event or right before it starts or during the event. As you have people walking around, as you're walking around, just do a live video that gets people's attention and then they get excited. Post some pictures of some of your pieces that you haven't posted yet in the advertising stage, which I talked about in video 2, link in the description. You could show sneak peeks of paintings or a picture of the food that you have. It's always a good idea. Also, show them pictures of some of the group activities you have. And then make sure you always tell them the time and the place, because people will forget and they want to be able to click an address and navigate immediately. So never forget to put that on pretty much every post, especially during your event. And then of course, you will open your doors and you will let everyone in and you will have fun. So I hope you found this video series helpful. Again, if you didn't see part 1 or 2, the links to those videos are in the description below, but I hope you go check them out. I hope you can share this with other artsy creative people that you know that might be interested in putting on their own show. But these are some of my tips and tricks for making a cohesive professional show, exhibiting your work, because you deserve to have your work seen. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope you can subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and we will see you next time. Bye.